Jeepney drivers in the Philippines are bracing for the impact of higher fuel prices. In Cavite, drivers say they would be greatly affected by the price increase. They point out their take-home pay would dwindle again since a chunk of their income will now be spent for diesel.
Liliit ang kita namin, wala nang kita ngayon. Tapos tulad niya, may mga estudyante ang kailangan babaunan at
mababawasan na po sa kasi sa krudo na mapupunta eh.
Motorists in the Philippines are in for another big time oil price hike. Diesel and kerosene prices will both go up by 6 pesos and 10 centavos per liter, while gasoline prices will see a smaller hike of 1 peso and 40 centavos. Industry players say the spike in prices is due to high oil demand, as some countries stock up on supply ahead of the winter season. Tight supply due to the war between Russia and Ukraine also continues to push crude prices higher. The controversial procurement service of the Budget Department asked to return 3 billion pesos to the Treasury Bureau. This after state auditors found the PSDBM has a high-yield savings account holding that amount. The source of the funds could not be specifically identified. The Audit Commission notes it is not in the mandate of the PSDBM to make investments. It also does not have the authority to invest in a high-yield savings account. The PSDBM has been mired in controversies surrounding government's purchase of questionable pandemic supplies and expensive laptops for the Education Department.
New COVID cases in the Philippines slightly lower on the fourth week of August. The country reported over 19,000 new infections from August 22nd to 28th, lower than the previous week's 23,000. The daily average, which is at 2,700, is also lower by 19%. Some 807 patients are in severe to critical condition. 316 deaths were also reported. The hospital bed utilization rate stands at 28.1%, while the ICU bed utilization rate nears 25%. Despite fewer cases, a health expert cautions the public against complacency. That's amid the health department's warning daily infections could rise to 9,000 in the next months.
I hope hindi mangyayari yan because those are projections at pwede nating mapipigilan yan by allowing ourselves to get the first booster for the eligible population and the second booster to be given to protect against severe infection. No? Kasi maski tataas ang mga kaso, let's say 9,000, 10,000, there's always the possibility na tataas din ang ma-admit sa hospital. And among those that will be admitted are the high risk or the vulnerable population.
Students and personnel attending face-to-face classes in higher education no longer need to present a proof of COVID vaccination. Vivian Gulia now joins us on the line for more details on that. Viv?
Hi, Ron. COVID-19 vaccination is no longer a requirement for students and personnel attending in-person classes in colleges and universities, according to Commission on Higher Education Chairperson Prospero De Vera III. De Vera said SHED lifted the COVID-19 vaccine requirement for face-to-face classes after consulting with health experts, assessing the current COVID situation in the country, and looking at trends abroad. Last year, SHED issued a joint memorandum circular that allowed only fully vaccinated students, teaching and non-teaching personnel to participate in face-to-face classes. But De Vera said since then, COVID-19 vaccination coverage in the country has increased, particularly for the age group of tertiary students. As of August 25th, reports received by CHED from higher education institutions show that over 3.1 million or 77% of tertiary students have been either partially or fully vaccinated against COVID, 260,661 or 90% of HEI personnel received partial or full COVID vaccine. Infectious disease specialist Dr. Ronjin Solante added, the student's age group is not at high risk of developing severe COVID. Department of Health Director Razel Nikahao noted that the agency is also seeing initial signs of decline in COVID cases in the country. The DOH said among the countries that have already removed the COVID vaccine mandate for attending face-to-face classes in higher education institutions are Australia, United Kingdom, Canada, New Zealand, and Singapore. CHED will issue a circular reflecting the policy shift and will transmit it to the IATF. The commission, meanwhile, urges higher education institutions to continue adhering to minimum health protocols like the wearing of face masks and conducting information campaigns on the benefits of COVID-19 vaccines. CHED encourages HEIs to hold another round of school-based COVID vaccination. Ron, back to you.
Yvian Goulian with that story. Thanks, Viv.